Good morning, students. So in the earlier class, we were discussing about money market instruments, right? So in that class, so far we have discussed repo rate, bank rate, marginal standing facility, and certificate of deposit, that is CDs, and term money, notice money, call money, etc., etc. Right? So far we have discussed repo rate, bank rate, marginal standing facility, certificate of deposit, call money, notice money, and term money. Right? In today's class, we are going to discuss in the earlier sessions, banks were needed money, short term money, and money market. One more time, I am stressing that money market instruments are meant for short term basis. That is for within a year, the entire transaction should be completed. Now, see, in the earlier sessions, we have discussed that whenever bank needs money, they go to RBI, they borrow at the rate called repo rate, and if they need some more money, the interbank transaction will take place. If that money also exhausted, then they go to the public for asking more money, etc., etc. Now, if, for example, any private sector companies, like, say, for example, Infosys needs 100 crore rupees for 1 year. 1 year in the sense, since we are discussing about money market, the entire transaction should be completed within a year, right? So if in case Infosys is a multinational company, MNC, in later classes we will discuss what are MNCs, how will they become MNC, etc., etc., right? So if in case a multinational company or a corporate called Infosys needs money 100 crore for 1 year, what are the options they have? Right? So they say that if anyone interested to lend 100 crore for 1 year at the rate of 7%, we need money. Infosys gives a newspaper advertisement, or it gives a notice to the public asking for 100 crore for 1 year at the rate of 7%. Now, seeing this, State Bank of India thinks that Infosys is a huge company, huge software company, and since it needs 100 crore for 1 year at the rate of 7%, State Bank of India thinks that I have surplus money with me, 100 crore. Why shouldn't I invest in Infosys? Why shouldn't I lend to Infosys for 1 year? That too, they are giving a great return, right? And now SBI says, fine, we will lend you 100 crore. Right? So, but what is the guarantee that you repay us back 100 crore, right? So what is the guarantee? SBI asks Infosys for guarantee. Now, Infosys says, fine, for guarantee we will make a stamp paper, and we will have a sign on it, authorized signatory, right? So we will give this stamp paper as a guarantee. Since Infosys, the case is Infosys needs 100 crore for 1 year for certain software project, and the SBI is ready to lend 100 crore for 1 year. So SBI needs guarantee for the repayment of entire 100 crores. So as a guarantee, Infosys is giving this stamp paper containing all the information. The 100 crore has borrowed for 1 year at the rate of 7%, and it is containing authorized signature from Infosys, right? So such kind of this, since this is an instrument, we are discussing about money market instrument. Money market instrument, which is meant for a short term money, right? So this entire transaction between Infosys and SBI is called as commercial paper, or very popular as CPs, right? So far we have discussed certificate of deposit, and now it is certificate of deposit is issued by a bank, issued by a commercial bank, right? So certificate, commercial paper, similar kind of certificate of deposit is issued by corporates, industries and multinational companies, right? So the main difference between certificate of deposit and commercial paper is certificate of deposit is issued by a commercial bank to general public, right? So commercial paper is issued by corporates, multinational companies and any other industries. So this is such type of document is considered as commercial paper. But how it works? Say for example, if you have a rented property, if you are going to rent your home in Sirsi town, so you cannot stand in a bus stand and you cannot call people that I am giving my home for rent, my house is for rent, my house is for rent, right? So you hire some broker, right? You hire some broker for renting out your house. So he, because you never have time for, you don't have time for all these things, right? So you hire a broker. Likewise, Infosys also don't have any time for doing all these things. So it hires a broker, and this is any commercial bank in the sense, bank should be registered with RBI, under RBI, right? So commercial bank may be, so it hires Canara Bank. Instead of asking directly to SBI, so the entire transaction is undertaken by bank, another commercial bank called Canara Bank, right? So Infosys asks Canara Bank to raise 100 crore money, and Canara Bank talks to SBI and SBI gives money. So the entire transaction takes place under commercial paper, and the document or agreement is called commercial paper. So commercial papers are those money market instruments issued by corporates, multinational companies and other industries to any other commercial banks for the short term fund requirement, right? It hires a certain it hires another commercial bank, and it goes to another commercial bank for doing all these process, right? So in this example, SBI is the lender, Infosys is the borrower, and Canara Bank acts as a middleman between SBI and Infosys. So the entire transaction is called as commercial paper, and this particular document is known as CP, commercial paper. Now, in your example, they ask to write a note on commercial paper. So commercial paper is nothing but it is a money market instrument issued by any corporates, any multinational companies or any other industries for raising short term fund, right? So we are discussing about one more money market instrument called commercial paper. So first of all, very easy to remember if we are preparing notes on point basis, right? So if you are going to write a short note on commercial paper, you have to know the things about commercial paper, how it works and what are the salient features of commercial paper, right? So already we have discussed commercial papers are issued by corporates, issued by multinational companies and issued by industries. One point to be noted down regarding commercial paper is, commercial paper is issued by not bank, not an individual, not any, not RBI, not government. It's only issued by corporates, multinational companies and industries, right? So who deal with this? Deal means the middleman and the lender dealing by commercial banks, right? Even lender is the commercial bank, and the person who acting as a middleman is also called, is also commercial banks. Now, so when it introduced in India, so commercial papers are introduced in the year of 1990. Right, we are discussing about commercial paper. Commercial paper is one of the money market instrument, and we are especially discussing all the money market instruments relevant to Indian money market. So commercial paper is introduced in India in the year of 1999, right? So what are the basic criteria these corporates or multinational companies or industry which is going to raise fund through issuing commercial paper? So that companies, these multinational companies or corporates, net worth should be more than 5 crores. I think you are aware of what is net worth is. If not, we will discuss later, right? So net worth of the company must be more than 5 crores. And we are discussing the commercial paper. You are aware that maturity period. Maturity period means the issuing of commercial paper and paying off the entire amount raised by issuing commercial paper should take place. The period, time period, right? So minimum maturity period is 7 days. That means within 7 days, the entire transaction is completed. That means borrowing and paying back that amount completes within 7 days. So minimum 7 days. Within 7 days, the entire transaction should be completed. And maximum, you are aware that 7 days is the minimum, and within a year, maximum, within 364 days, you have to pay back the entire amount being raised by issuing commercial paper, right? So what is the minimum amount? What is the minimum amount can be raised by issuing commercial paper, right? So minimum amount you can raise, minimum amount you can raise is rupees 5 lakhs, and the important thing to be remembered is minimum you have to raise 5 lakh rupees by issuing commercial paper. If you are going to issue, you are a multinational company, if you are raising fund by issuing commercial paper, and the minimum amount should be 5 lakh, and amount should be multiplies of 5 lakhs. That means you can issue commercial paper containing amount 5 lakh multiplies of 5 lakh. That means 10 lakh, 15 lakh, 20 lakh, 25, 50, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 5, 1 lakh, 1 lakh, 1 point, 1 lakh 25,000, sorry, etc., etc., right? So minimum amount should be raised 5 lakh, and maximum there is no limit, but the amount should be multiples of 5 lakhs, right? And the seventh point, or the last point, it is for every money market instrument, that the instrument is issued at a discount to the face value. Discount to the face value, if you are raising if you are raising 10 lakh rupees by issuing commercial paper, then you may be issuing at 9.5 lakh. That means if you are issuing to the State Bank of India, State Bank of India lends only 9.5 lakh. While paying back, you have to pay entire 10 lakhs, right? So that means the paper, commercial paper containing 10 lakh rupees is being issued at 9.5 lakh. That means that 50,000 you are issuing at the discount rate of 50,000, right? So these are the 7 points to be remembered for commercial paper. See, the main difference between certificate of deposit and commercial paper is certificate of deposit is issued by bank, commercial banks, and this commercial paper is issued by any corporates, multinational companies, or any other industries, right? So far we have discussed that if any bank is borrowing from RBI, the money market instruments are called repo rate, bank rate, and marginal standing facilities. And if the the bank is borrowing, it is called as call money. Interbank transaction takes place. If the commercial bank is borrowing from another commercial bank, the money market instruments are call money, notice money, and term money. Right? If any bank is borrowing from general public or private multinational companies or any other industries, it is called certificate of deposits. One more commercial paper that I think it is the 8th money market instrument we are discussing is commercial papers. Commercial papers are issued by multinational companies or private sector companies and any other industries to commercial banks. And one more commercial bank acts as a middleman between this company and another commercial bank, which looks after entire transaction, borrowing and paying back of entire borrowed money, right? So these are the 7 features we have discussed in this class related to commercial paper. That one thing is to remember, that issued by corporates and multinational companies. And one more thing is, it is dealt by commercial bank. It is introduced in the year of 1990 in India, and the network, the company's network must be more than 5 crores if that company is going to raise fund through issuing commercial paper. Then maturity period of commercial paper, minimum 7 days. Within 7 days, the entire transaction should be completed, or maximum 364 days. That is within a year. That's why it is considered as money market instrument. Then minimum amount the company is raising is 5 lakh, and the amount should be multiples of 5 lakhs, and maximum there is no limit, right? So one more feature is, this commercial paper is issued at discount to the face value. Face value in the sense, if the company is issuing at 5 lakh, it may be issuing at 4.5 lakh. That 50,000 is considered as discount to the face value, because the amount mentioned in the agreement or commercial paper is 5 lakh. If the company is borrowing 4.5 lakh and the commercial bank is lending only 4.5 lakh, that 50,000 is considered as discount amount, right? So these are the 7 features of commercial papers, and commercial paper is 8 money market instrument we have discussed so far. And I think in the earlier class, which we were discussing in through PPT, I have given as a notes, right? These features, if I insist, you can note down into your notebook, right? You can note somewhere so that you can easily remember all these points. Now, so far we have discussed, if the bank needs money, bank goes to RBI, Reserve Bank. If that money is exhausted, it goes to another commercial bank, raising fund by issuing call money, notice money, term money. And that money is also exhausted, then it goes to general public for further funds. And that instrument is called as certificate of deposits. And we have discussed the features of certificate of deposits also. In short, it is called as CDs. And 8th money market instrument we have discussed is commercial paper. That means whenever bank needs money, there are some money market instruments. Whenever there are any company needs, any industry needs, any multinational company needs money, there is a money market instrument called commercial paper. Now, what about since we are discussing Indian money market instrument, we are very particular about, we are very particular about Indian money market instrument and Indian capital market and money market instrument, Indian financial market itself, right? So whenever government needs money, government, when it needs, or what are the two criteria government needs? Government needs fund for short term, and government needs fund for long term. Short term, government have to pay salaries, government have to pay pension, and government have to pay certain fund for short term basis, etc., etc. Long term, government needs money for construction of bridges, dams, and national highways, etc., etc., right? So these are the long term requirements, fund requirement by any government. There are need for short-term basics also for paying salaries and any other short-term requirements. For long-term, government issues national savings certificate, Kisan Vikas Patra, KVP. We have these instruments for long-term basis. These instruments matures after 5 years, after 6 years, 10 years, etc., etc. These two market instrument we are discussing, Kisan Vikas Patra and National Savings Certificate, right? So for short term, in the last class also, we were discussing treasury bills and cash management bills. So treasury bills, need to remember, is always treasury means government. So treasury bills are always issued by government only. And another one is cash management bill, right? So these are the short-term fund requirements. These are the things with the help of government, fulfills its short-term fund requirements, right? So who gives the money to government of India or government, any other government, right? Since we are discussing Indian financial system and Indian financial markets, so government of India raises money by ways and means advances. That means if government of India needs money, it asks Reserve Bank of India, right? Bankers Bank. Reserve Bank of India is also called as Bankers Bank in India. And Reserve Bank act as a central bank, right? So government of India, whenever needs money, and it asks RBI for fund, right? So now, what is the time period this RBI gives fund to government of India? So what is the time period government of India has to return that money? Within 90 days. So government of India needs money for short-term basis, and it asks the Reserve Bank of India for fund. Reserve Bank of India gives money to government of India, and the maximum time period government of India is having to repay its borrowed money is maximum 90 days. And what will be the interest rate government of India gives to RBI? So interest rate for ways and means advances, WMA, one more money market instrument. So whenever we are discussing the need of fund by government, whenever there is a fund requirement, government asks Central Bank, that is Reserve Bank of India, for money. and Reserve Bank of India lends money to Government of India, and the maximum time period Government of India is having to repay borrowed money is 90 days. And for the same fund, RBI is charging the interest rate as same as repo rate. So repo rate already we have discussed. Repo rate is the rate at which commercial banks borrow from RBI, or the rate at which RBI lends to any other commercial bank. Right? So we are discussing one more money market instrument called ways and means advances, also called as WMA. In this case, Government of India borrows money from RBI for the time period of 90 days, and it is paying interest as same as repo rate. What happens if, in case, the first money market instrument is repo rate? And I remember in the, during 2019, from July, August, September, for 3 months period, that is 90 days, Government of India has raised money of 75,000 crore rupees from RBI. So in the month of July, July to September, for the time period of July to September, Government of India has raised 75,000 crores in the year of 2019, it seems. I remember in the year of 2019, with the help of money market instrument called Ways and Means Advances, or WMA, Government of India has raised 75,000 crore rupees from RBI with the help of money market instrument called WMA, and the time period is 90 days. That's why July, August, September, 3 months. So within 90 days, government had paid back its borrowed money, right? What happens if government fails to repay this amount within 90 days, or the time period exceeds 90 days? The same thing which is very related to WMA is called as overdraft. Overdraft, we consider this as one more money market instrument. So if government borrows from RBI and fails to pay this amount to RBI, then the same loan or same fund is considered as overdraft, and RBI gives 10 more days to repay this amount, and we call it as overdraft. And what will be the interest rate? Since government has failed to repay its borrowed money, RBI have to penalize government now, because it have to. So repo rate in case of overdraft, the RBI charges repo rate plus 2% more. 2% more along with repo rate. And we are discussing about the need, fund requirement by government. And whenever government needs money, there are two instruments with the help of RBI government raises fund. One is ways and means advances, and maximum time period to pay back is 90 days. If government fails to pay this amount within 90 days, and the same amount, same borrowed fund is considered as overdraft, and RBI gives 10 more days for repaying this loan amount, and RBI charges 2% more along with repo rate, right? So when government borrows from RBI and the entire amount is exhausted, government needs some more fund now. Now, what are the steps available to government? We will discuss in next class. Thank you.